Today concept name is static testing. Static testing. Today concept name is static testing. Static testing. Without performing any actions on the application, we can test the application. So the type of testing is known as static testing. Without performing any actions on the application, we can test the application. So the type of testing is known as static testing. Without performing any action, can we test the application? Is it possible? Without performing any actions on the application, we can test the application. So the type of testing is known as static testing. Without performing any action, can we test the application? Is it possible?
No, sir. It's not possible.
How we can test? How we can test? Without performing any actions on the application, we can test the application. So the type of testing is known as static testing. So without performing any actions, this static testing is called GUI testing. GUI means graphical user interface. Graphical user interface testing. So without performing any actions on the application, we can test the application. So the type of testing is known as static testing. For example, customer said he want 4 buttons in the application. So 4 buttons available or not. No need to perform any actions. Without performing any actions, we can see and say. That means availability. Availability. All buttons are available or not. No need to perform any actions. Without performing any actions, we can see and say. Alignment is good or not. No need to perform any actions. Without performing any actions, we can see and say. Consistency. Each and every button is consistency with each other. Consistent with each other. Consistency. And spelling. And color. Without performing any actions, in these 5 ways we can test the application. So the type of testing is known as static testing or GUI testing. GUI means graphical user interface. Graphical user interface. Without performing any actions on the application, we can test the application. So the type of testing is known as static testing. So the type of testing is known as static testing. So best example is document review or code review. Code review or document review. Code review or document review. Without performing any actions, we can see and say. The type of testing is known as static testing. Code review or document review is the best example. So our colleague wrote one code. So we are checking. So no need to perform any actions. Code is correct or not. So no need to perform any actions. Without performing any actions, we can see and say. So the type of testing is known as static testing. Next one is dynamic testing. Dynamic testing. Compulsory, we need to perform some actions on the functionality. Then only we can say that functionality is properly working or not. The type of testing is known as dynamic testing. Compulsory. We should perform some actions on the functionality, then only we can say that functionality is properly working or not. The type of testing is known as dynamic testing. So best example, functional testing. Add button is properly working or not. How we know? Compulsory, we should take some values into value 1 and value 2. If you click on add button, then only we can say. For example, functional testing. Functional testing. What is functional testing? Without performing any actions. Without performing any actions, add button is properly working or not. How we can tell. So it is very impossible. So compulsory we should take some values into value 1 and value 2. If you click on add button, then based on the result, add button is properly working or not, we can find out. Otherwise we can't. So this is called functional testing. Compulsory we should perform some actions on the functionality. Then only we can say that functionality is properly working or not. The type of testing is known as dynamic testing. The type of testing is known as dynamic testing. The type of testing is known as dynamic testing. Next testing, alpha testing, beta testing. Next testing, alpha testing, beta testing. Next testing, alpha testing. Sixth one, alpha testing. Next one is beta testing. So alpha testing, beta testing, both are user acceptance testings. Both are user acceptance testings. Both are user acceptance testings. User acceptance testings. User acceptance testings. Both are user acceptance testings. What do you mean by user acceptance testing? What do you mean by alpha testing? First of all, we should know what is user acceptance testing. Same system testing, same system testing. After installing the application into one environment, we will perform different types of testings on that application. We will perform different types of testing, different types of testing that application. After installing the application into one environment, we will perform different types of testing on that application in front of the user, presence of the user, we will do testing. So that's why that is called user acceptance testing. Beta testing also one of the user acceptance testing. After installing the application into one environment, we will perform different types of testings. In front of the user, we will do. Both are user acceptance testings. Alpha testing we will do in our company. Our resources, our people will do. Beta testing, same. It is also user acceptance testing, but so third party people, they are doing in third party location. That is called beta testing. What are the advantages of alpha testing? What are the disadvantages of beta testing? Tell me, madam, guess it. What are the advantages of alpha testing? What are the disadvantages of beta testing?
Our people, our company, sir.
What is the,
that is the main the advantage. Our company. In our company, we will do tests, sir.
What is the advantage? What are the advantages? Main advantages. While doing testing in our company, if at all any defect found, then there is a chance of rectifying immediately. On this part, we can rectify the problem. So that is alpha testing advantage. Beta testing means third party people, they are doing in third party location. If they get any defect, one second they need to send to our company only. That is a bad name for the company. The company people, while doing testing, if they get any defect, they will discover. So-and-so Infosys people, they developed one application, that application is not working. So they will discuss badly our company. So that is the reason, that is the beta testing. Beta testing disadvantage. Alpha testing advantage is, while doing testing, if at all any defect found, then there is a chance of rectifying immediately. So done in our company, our people. So inside company only, that problem will be rectified. So beta testing means, beta testing when we will do, already I told you, beta testing means, so for example, Infosys, they developed one application. So after developing the application, the testing team is not ready to test the application. In that situation, that company people, they will give to the project to another company. Another company people will do testing. Another company people will do testing. While doing testing, if they get any defect, once again they need to send to our company only. Why? Because beta companies don't have any developers. Only just testers will be there. So while doing testing, if they get any defect, once again they need to send to our company. So that company people will discuss about badly about our company. That is the drawback. That is a bad name for the company. That is the reason all the companies will not encourage beta testing. That is the reason in Hyderabad city we have 3,000 plus companies, but we have 2 to 3 companies for beta testing. So very less people, very less people, only 1 or 2 companies for beta testing. None of the people not encouraging beta testing nowadays. Okay, why? Because that is a bad name for the company. Inside, if it is alpha testing inside only, we can rectify the problem. That is the inside company only we can do it. Beta testing means third party people, they will do in third party location. While doing testing, if they get one, if they get any defect, they will discuss about our company badly. Okay. Madam.
Sir.
Got it, huh?
Sir, got it, sir.
Right. So that both are user acceptance testing. Alpha testing, beta testing, both are user acceptance testing. Okay, right. Only we have only 2 user acceptance testings. One is alpha, second one is beta. Next testing, installation testing. 8th one, installation testing. Installation testing. Installation testing. Installation testing. Installation testing. Installation testing means after developing the application, after testing the application, we need to go to customer place and we need to install the application into client environment. After developing the application, after testing the application, we need to go to customer place and we need to install the application into client environment. If at all installation successful, then we can come to a conclusion that the given guidelines correct. Otherwise, we can come to a conclusion that the given guidelines not correct. So that is called installation testing. After developing the application, so we need to go to customer place and we need to install the application. So if at all installation successful, then we can come to a conclusion that the given guidelines correct. Otherwise, we can come to a conclusion that the given guidelines not correct. So that is called installation testing. So after developing the application, after testing the application, only installation purpose, some companies they will maintain deployment engineers. So all the companies will not maintain deployment engineers. Only some companies only they will maintain deployment engineers. The deployment engineers will go to customer place and they will install the application into client environment. If at all installation successful, they will come to a conclusion that the given guidelines correct. Otherwise, they will come to a conclusion that the given guidelines not correct. They will not apply our own ideas. They will not apply own ideas. Whatever they given installation document, each and every software company installation purpose, they will provide installation document, how to install the application into client environment. They will provide some guidelines. Using that guidelines, we will install the application into client environment. If at all installation successful, then we can come to a conclusion that the given guidelines are correct. Otherwise, we can come to a conclusion that the given guidelines are not correct. That is installation testing. So installation testing also we will do. Installation testing also we will do. Next, compatibility testing. Next, compatibility testing. Compatibility testing. Very important testing, madam. Compatibility testing. So what is compatibility testing? We will discuss now. Compatibility testing means compatibility testing. So for example, one second. compatibility testing. Compatibility testing means, so, sir, are you there, Charan garu? Not yet come. Compatibility testing. For example, ICIC bank people want one software. ICICI bank people want a software. So they said the developer project should work in Windows 7 environment. Then we will choose the technology. Which technology suits for Windows 7? We will choose three technologies like Java or PHP. That in. We will choose any of the technology and we will develop the application. We will develop the application. Only if you satisfy the only Windows 7 environment, that is more than enough. So this is called project-based company. This is called project-based company. Customer said only one requirement. If you fulfill the customer requirement, more than enough. If you fulfill the customer requirement, that is more than enough. That is project-based company. Okay. Microsoft people, they want to introduce Microsoft people, they want to introduce one software into market. X software. So they want to introduce this software into market. First of all, they need to, if they want to introduce into market, first of all, they need to install into XP. Windows 7. Windows 8, Windows 10, Mac, like we need to install first of all. Well, why? Because this is the product they want to introduce into market. Worldwide people, different operating systems they may use. So first of all, we need to install into different operating systems. So only all the people will not use, only XP people. All the XP people will not use that software. All different operating systems people, they may use this software. So that time it is properly working or not. In the XP already they installed Oracle software. In that situation it is working or not. Windows 7, already they installed SQL Server. That time it is working or not. Windows 8, already they installed Java. That time it is working or not. Windows 10, already they installed something SAP. That time it is working or not. Mac, already installed Selenium. In that situation, it is working or not. So, different possible combinations we need to create and we need to install. So if it is working, then only we will go to we will deliver the application into market. So they will deliver the application into market, otherwise they will not deliver it. Why? Because this is the product based company. So what is compatibility testing? Compatibility testing also one of the type of testing in which one will deploy the application into different possible combinations. If it is working, then only they will install the application into environment or they will deliver the application into market. So that is called compatibility testing. Compatibility testing max we can use in product based companies. Compatibility testing max we will do in product based companies. So got it ma? Project and product. If you satisfy the only single customer requirement, that is the more than enough, that is project. Product means worldwide people, not only India people, worldwide people, different operating system people they may use. So while working that application, it is working or not with different possible combinations. First of all, they will create that environment in their company. If it is working, then only they will deliver the application to market. That is called product. So in the product based companies only we will do compatibility testing. Compatibility testing also one of the type of testing in which one will deploy the application into different possible combinations. If it is working in different possible combinations, then only they will install the they will deliver the application to market. That is compatibility testing. Next testing, usability testing. Next testing, usability testing. Next testing, usability. Usability means user friendly. Usability means user friendly. Usability testing. Next testing, usability testing. Usability means user friendly. Usability means user friendly. Usability means user friendly. Not only justifying the customer requirements. If it is justifying the customer requirement, that is not quality application. That should be user friendly. That should be user friendly. That should be user friendly. Then only we can say that application is quality application. If it is justifying the customer requirement, that is not quality application. That is not quality application. That is not quality application. If it is justifying the customer requirement, that is not quality application. That should be user friendly. That should be user friendly. Then only we can say that is quality application. Then only we can say that is quality application. Usability testing. After developing the application, after testing the application, compulsory we need to do testing based on the customer requirement. If it is working or not, it is very user friendly or not, we will do testing. So that's why that is called usability testing. That's why that is called usability testing. Usability testing also very very important. Customer will not say, just do usability testing, but compulsory we need to do. A tester compulsory, he need to do or we need to do usability testing. Not only justifying the customer requirement. If you justify the customer requirement, that is not quality application, that should be user friendly. Then only we can say that application is user friendly application. We have number of browsers like Google Chrome, Opera, Internet Explorer, Mozilla, Firefox. We have number of browsers. But wherever you go, most of the people, which browser they will use? We have number of browsers, madam. Google Chrome, Opera, Internet Explorer, Mozilla, Firefox. We have number of browsers. But wherever you go, max people they will use one browser. Which browser? Google Chrome.
Google.
Why they will use Google Chrome? It is very user friendly.
Yes.
For example, so in India, in Andhra, we have a number of phones like Nokia, Sony, Ericsson, and Samsung, iPhone. We have number of phones. So, but most of the people, they will use Nokia people. Nokia. Even farmers, even illiterate people also, they will use Nokia. Why they will use Nokia? Options is very easy. Call, cut to message. 1100. So still number of people, they are using 1100. Why they are using? It is very user friendly.
So, yes.
Okay, for example, you are going to ATM machine. So after going to ATM machine, after inserting the card, it will ask you, please enter your password.
Remember.
You will enter password. Then choose your account type. We will choose account type saving account. So how much you want, it will ask you. We will enter the money. Do you want a receipt? It will ask you. Yes, it will give the receipt. And it will give the money also. That is user friendly. It is navigating. It is navigating, so that is called user friendly. So user friendly or not, after developing the application, after testing the application, application is user friendly or not, we will do testing. So that's why that is called usability testing. Right. Next, end-to-end testing. End-to-end testing. Next testing, end-to-end testing. Next testing, end-to-end testing. Next testing, end-to-end testing. First, I'm going to bank. First of all, I need to log in. I'm doing money transaction. I'm going to bank. I'm doing login. Money transfer. Money withdraws. Cash deposit. Logout. Login done by me, logout also done by me. Login is starting scenario, logout is ending scenario. Starting scenario is to ending scenario if you work with any application, so that is called end to end testing. That is called end to end testing. Starting scenario is to ending scenario if you work with any application, so that is called end to end testing. That is called end to end testing. Starting scenario is to ending scenario if you work with any application, so that is called end to end testing. That is called end to end testing. Next testing, expert testing. Expert testing. In market, we have different domains: banking domain, finance, healthcare, educational, insurance. We have different domains. For example, if you are working with banking domain from past 15 years, you will become a expert. You will become a expert. So in market, we have different domains: banking domain, finance, healthcare, educational domain, and insurance domain. We have different domains. So for example, if you are working with one domain in past, you are working in one domain from past 10 years or 15 years, you will become a expert. You are working with only single domain, so you will become an expert. So this domain experts, without having any customer requirement document, directly they can perform testing on the application. So that type of testing is known as expert testing. Only domain experts can do this type of testing without having any customer requirement document. So if you want to test any application, compulsory we should take customer requirements, then only we can test. But domain experts, without having any customer requirement document, directly they can perform testing on the application. So that type of testing is known as expert testing. Expert testing. Right. Next, monkey testing. Next testing, monkey testing. Monkey testing means if one perform abnormal actions on the application, intentionally. So for example, if you want to click on add button, first of all, we need to enter value 1 and value 2. We can click on add button. So then we can check add button is properly working or not. That is normal testing. Without taking any values into value 1 and value 2, if you click on add button, that is called abnormal reaction. So if you want to add button is properly working or not, if you want to know, then we will enter 10 into value 1. We will enter 20 into value 2. If you click on add button, 30 is coming or not, we will check. That is normal reaction. Without taking any values into value 1 and value 2, directly we will click on add button. So that's why that is called abnormal reaction. Why we are doing abnormal reaction? That is called abnormal reaction. Intentionally we are doing. Why we need to do? So in order to find out the stability of the application, if one perform abnormal actions on the application intentionally, we are doing. So why we are doing? In order to find out the stability of the application. So the type of testing is known as monkey testing. So for example, I will tell you only one point, madam. So monkey testing is a one of the negative type of testing. A test engineer should have negative mindset of, then only he will become a good test engineer. So not only right values, sometimes we should take wrong values also. It is working or not. So valid inputs means right username, right password. Wrong username, wrong password is nothing but invalid inputs. Right? Why we need to take every time right username, right password? If I take wrong username, wrong password, then only it is working or not. We need to take the values. So that is called abnormal reaction. Abnormal reaction or native testing. Native testing also very, very important for test engineer. So whenever developing the developers, they will use positive mindset. So if you do positive testing, you can't get more defects. So native testing also very, very important. For example, we have an application. So fast two testing, I can take 10 in the place of val one, I can take 20 in the place of val two. I'm clicking an add button. Add button is properly working or not. Okay, this is fast two testing. So this is the normal reaction. This is the normal reaction. This is the normal reaction. So without taking any values into value one and value two, I'm clicking an add button. So this is abnormal reaction. This is abnormal reaction. If I click on OK button, application will be closed. So this is not stable application. That is not correct application. So without taking any values into value one and value two, just it need to show. Oh no 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 no. Just you should enter your values. It need to show. That is the communication. That is the user friendly. But it is not showing anything. Just a type mistake. Something it is showing a type mistake. If I click on add button directly, it is showing a runtime error 13 type mistake. What is this nonsense? So this is not user friendly. This is not user friendly. So if I click directly add button, that is called abnormal reaction. Why we are doing? In order to find out the stability of the application. So the type of testing is known as monkey testing. So the type of testing is known as monkey testing. All right. Monkey testing. If one perform abnormal reactions on the application. Monkey testing means if one perform abnormal reactions on the application. If one perform abnormal reactions on the application intentionally I am doing. So that is called monkey testing. Like next testing, reliability testing. Reliability testing. If one perform continuous reactions on the application. Continuous reactions on the application. If one perform continuous reactions on the application. If one perform continuous reactions on the application intentionally in order to find out the stability of the application. So the type of testing is known as reliability testing. Reliability testing and monkey testing both are belongs to SOAK testings. Both are belongs to SOAK testings. Both are belongs to SOAK testings. Both are belongs to SOAK. If one perform continuous actions on the application intentionally in order to find out the stability of the application, so the type of testing is known as monkey testing. Sorry, reliability testing. For example, I bought new iPhone. I want to check how many hours it is giving backup. So then I will play the music, I will play the games, continuously I will work with that application. I will work with that phone. So how many hours it is giving backup, I want to find out. So that is called a reliability testing. Reliability testing also one of the type of testing in which one will perform continuous actions on the application intentionally in order to find out the stability of the application. So the type of testing is known as reliability testing. Reliability testing and monkey testing both are belongs to SOAK testings. Both are belongs to SOAK testings. Both are belongs to SOAK testings. Right. Next testing, port testing. Port is nothing but client place. 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 Port testing. Port means client place. Port is nothing but client place. In the installation testing, we will go to customer place and we will install the application into client environment. So that is installation testing. Port testing means after installing the application into client environment, within that environment application is properly working or not, we will do testing. So that's why that is called port testing. So after installing the application into client environment, within that environment application is properly working or not, we will do testing. So that's why that is called port testing. So port is nothing but client place. After installing the application, so installation testing, we will go to customer place and we will install the application into client environment. That is installation testing. After installing the application into client environment, application is properly working or not, we will do testing. So that's why that is called port testing. Port testing. Port testing. Next testing. Port testing. Next testing. Mutation testing. Mutation testing. After developing the application, if you do any changes to that application, so that is called mutation testing. What is this? So after developing the application, developers will develop the application. After developing the application, if you do any changes to that application, so that is called port testing. So compulsory every project we will do some changes. Changes means, so based on the customer requirement, if it is not working, if it is not do, if it is not there, then compulsory we will raise the defect. They will rectify and they will send once again to testing department. So that is means we will raise the defect or we will raise the complaint. Okay, we will give the suggestion or we will give something. So that is called request or order, whatever it is. So they will do some changes. So we will raise the defect, we will raise the request, they will do some changes. So changes done by developers only, but we will do the changes. We will do the changes means directly we will not do, we will raise the complaint, developers will do. So that's why that is called mutation test. Next, ad hoc testing. First three, and this one is very, very important. First three, build acceptance testing, regression testing, retesting is important. After that, ad hoc testing. What is ad hoc testing? Ad hoc testing. Okay. For example, you have some work. You are in working in software company. You have some work. So if you do daily 10 hours, it will take 1 month. If you want to complete this work, if you do daily 10 hours, it will take 1 month. It will take 1 month. If you do daily 10 hours, it will take 1 month. It will take 1 month. This is the 30-day work. But suddenly your team lead came to your cabin and you are saying, madam, at any cost you should complete this work today itself. What will you do? Actually, that work, if you do daily 10 hours, it will take 1 month. Okay? Suddenly, your team lead came to your cabin and he is asking, madam, at any cost you should complete this work today itself. You should complete this work today itself. What will you do? We will do ad hoc testing. We will do ad hoc testing. We will do ad hoc testing. After understanding the requirements very clearly, our own style we will do testing. Our own style we will do testing. So that's why that is called ad hoc testing. After understanding the requirements very clearly, our own style we will do testing. Our own style we will do testing. So that's why that is called ad hoc testing. After understanding the requirements very clearly, our own style we will do testing. Something is better than nothing. So something is better than nothing. So successfully we can't complete this work. This is the 1 month work, madam. If you want to complete only 1 day, it is impossible. I know. But even your team lead also know. But still he is saying. Why he is saying? So that is the requirement. That is the customer requirement. Customer want only today only. So if you want to complete that work, it is impossible. But so we can't complete successfully, but we need to do something. That time we will do ad hoc testing. We will do ad hoc testing. After understanding the requirements very clearly, our own style we will do testing. So that's why that is called ad hoc testing. Okay. Last testing, security testing. Madam, are you getting sleep, madam?
No, sir.
Why? Because manual testing only theory, no? Security testing.
Okay.
Security testing. Security testing we will do in three ways. Security testing we will do in three ways. One is authentication testing. Second one is direct URL testing. Firewall leakage testing. Security testing we will do in three ways: authentication testing, direct URL testing, firewall leakage testing. Three ways we will do security testing. After developing the application, compulsory we should provide some security. We should provide some security. So security testing, authentication testing, direct URL testing, firewall leakage testing. So compulsory we should provide some security. So first one is authentication testing. Authentication testing. Customer said he want one application that username should be AAA, that username should be AAA, password should be BBB. Username should be AAA, password should be BBB. Username should be AAA, password should be BBB. That is the customer requirement. Not only right username, right password. We will give wrong username, wrong password. In that situation also, application is allowing or not, we will do testing. So that's why that is called authentication testing. Not only correct username, correct password. Using correct username, correct password, it is working. If I take wrong username, wrong password also, it is working or not, we will do testing. So that's why that is called authentication testing. Not only right username, right password. I know, still I am doing. Not only right username, right password. So I will take wrong username, wrong password. In that situation, it is working or not, we will do testing. So that's why that is called authentication testing. Not only right username, right password, we will take wrong username, wrong password. So in that situation, it is working or not, we will do testing. So that's why that is called authentication testing. Next, direct URL testing. After opening our mail, top of the page, we can get our mail URL. Mail URL. We can get our mail URL. Using that URL, if they want access that page, application is opening or not, application is allowing or not, we will do testing. So that's why that is called direct URL testing. Okay. After opening our mail or any website or any site, your personal site, so top of the page you can get one URL. Facebook also you can get one URL. Your YouTube account also, it will show you one URL. Top of the page you can get URL. So using that URL, if they want access, in that situation it is allowing or not, we will do testing. So that's why that is called direct URL testing. Okay, direct URL testing. Using that URL, they are accessing the application or not. So it is allowing or not, we will do testing. So that's why that is called direct URL testing. Next, firewall leakage testing. Third one, firewall leakage testing. Each and every software company, they will maintain common repository. Each and every software company, they will maintain common repository. Common repository is nothing but it is a storage place where we can store the total company information, so that is called common repository. Common repository is nothing but it is a storage place where we can store the total company information, upcoming project information, recently completed project information, total employees, total turnover, everything they will store in one repository. So repository is nothing but it is a storage place where we can store the total company information. Why? Because software job is not a permanent job. So that's the reason. So today employee, tomorrow he may leave the company. So it is not a permanent position. So software company employees will be changed regularly companies. Why? Because it is not a permanent job. If they get any good salary or good package, then they can change the company. So that is the common repository. So normal. So common repository is nothing but it is a storage place where we can store the total company information. Each and every software company, compulsory they will maintain common repository. Okay, right. Okay. If you want to access this information, if you want to, we can download and we can upload the information. If you have username and password, we can download and we can upload the information. So based on the person, designation, so username and password will be the each and every employee having username and password. I am the testing unit. I have username and password. Using username and password, I can access up to here only. I am the testing unit only. Using my username and password, I can access up to here. Team lead. Using his username and password, he can access up to here. Project lead. Using his username and password, he can access up to here. project lead. Total company CEO. He has username and password. He can access entire information. So he can access, he can edit, he can delete everything. So he has superpowers. So while working with software company, each and every company will provide you username and password. Using that username and password, you can access that company information. That company information. Today concept is firewall leakage testing. What is firewall leakage testing? One level of users using username and password. If you want to access other level of pages, it is allowing or not, we will do testing. So that's why that is called firewall leakage testing. One level of users, if they want to access other level of pages, in that situation it is allowing or not, we will do testing. So that's why that is called firewall leakage testing. One level of users using his username and password, they want to access other level of pages. In that situation, it is allowing or not, we will do testing. So that's why that is called firewall leakage testing. So this is the security testing. So these are the 18 types of testing. Yesterday we learned 3 types, remaining 15 today we discussed. So today we discussed alpha testing, beta testing, static testing, dynamic testing, installation testing, compatibility testing, and usability testing, monkey testing, port testing, reliability testing, expert testing, end-to-end testing, ad hoc testing, mutation testing, security testing. So today we discuss 15 types. These are the type of testing concept, madam. Whenever you are working with the software company, we will perform only one type of testing. But whenever we are learning, we will learn all the types of testing. But whenever you are working, we will perform only one type of testing or half type of testing only. One type of testing or half type of testing only. That is the concept to types of testing. That is the concept to types of testing. Charan garu,
sir.
Yeah, this is the type of testing. Types of testing is over. Types of testing.
Yeah, okay, sir.